so many questions on the Facebook groups for Divi theme users and WordPress, frankly, are how do I set up a WordPress install on a dev server? How do I install Divi? And how do I install a child theme? And once I've made my amendments, how do I then port that to a live site? So this is a deep dive into all of that with Andrew Palmer from Elegant Marketplace. So as you can see above here, I've got marketing collateral. This is my business for hosting, and I've got a little thing called artworkarchive.co.uk, and this is where I do all of my testing. So I've dialed into my control panel, and all I do is I scroll down, and you'll see something very similar to this in your control panels if you've got a control panel based hosting. If you're using something like Flywheel or WP Engine, which we like as well, it'll be completely different, and you can just set up stuff there. So I found my WordPress blog. I'm going to install that now, and I'm going to call it child theme install. I'm going to install it into a separate folder, and that'll only give me an option to install a single blog unit. And so that's been installed to there. So we're going to give this a title of child theme install. I'm going to change that username to Andrew, and I'm going to keep that password as well. Check your spelling on all your emails. I tend to misspell things. And I'm going to discourage the search engines from indexing this site. That's quite important. That's another question that gets asked as well. So as soon as you install your WordPress, just discourage the search engines from the very start. I'm going to not save that password. I'm going to log in now. And it's going to be Andrew. And the password that I copied and pasted, I'm going to ask it to remember me because I'm a bit lazy like that. And there we are. We have a new WordPress install. I'm just going to add this to my password manager. I'm going to update to the latest version of WordPress, which is 4.8.1 at this time. I'm basically making sure that the WordPress is a completely clean install, and I'm going to update all the plugins that come with WordPress as well. So WordPress is installed. I'm going to go to my plugins, and I'm going to see that they need updating. So I'm just going to go to the update available and simply update all of them. Now, I tend not to use Jetpack. It's a bit controversial, but it's actually quite a good program if you use it properly. So read the manual on Jetpack, and there are some really quite good things in there. There's some security situations. I quite like Akismet anti-spam as well. I tend not to use Insight for WP personalization made easy, but it's quite a good thing as well. So just have a look at all these things and learn about what WordPress actually installs into your website straight away. So now it's time to install the latest version of Divi. So I go to Appearance, Themes, Add New Theme, Upload Theme, choose my file. Now I've got a certain place where I keep my updates, and it's called Divi version control, and here's the latest version now. Now it does take some time to install this. WordPress, or Divi rather, when it first came out was a couple of megabytes, and now it's 7 meg, and depending on your connection it can take a little while to upload to your server, decompress and install the theme. So that's now installed. I can activate that. Now, one of the things that I like about Divi is that it does actually tell you to read the Divi documentation or have a look at the documentation. And I totally recommend reading the manual. It's quite surprising how many people don't know where the Divi documentation is. But when you install Divi, it tells you exactly where it is. So go and have a look at that as well if you're new to Divi. And even if you're an older Divi user, It's always a good idea to go there because they do update it from time to time. And certainly at the moment, there are some very brand new Divi documentation bits and pieces around, especially around the visual builder. So take advantage of the service that Elegant Themes offer and go and read the Divi documentation. Right, moving on swiftly, we'll just add a new theme. Now I've downloaded a theme from Elegant Marketplace, obviously, and I'm going to upload that theme. I'm going to go and find it, and I'm using the medical child theme here. I've unzipped the file. Generally, when you download a child theme from Elegant Marketplace, it will say unzip me. This particular one doesn't, but you know, if you've got problems with style.css not showing up, that means that the theme or the theme file has got other files in it, and you need to open it up and have a look at the documentation and obviously go into the child theme itself and install the child theme. So we just select that and we hit install now. Now that's been uploaded, so we can activate that. So now on this particular child theme, we have to go to the Divi library and install the layouts. So what we do is we just hit portability, import, choose the file, and then we go to medical child theme layouts JSON. That's a 4 megabyte file, so it may take a little while to import. So we're going to import all of the Divi Builder layouts, and hopefully it will import without any issues. Now, if you have a particularly slow server, or your server isn't running PHP 5.6, which all servers need to use as a minimum for Divi, then have a word with your host and they can change it for you. Or you may be able to change that in your own control panel. So that's all nicely imported, and we can go to all our pages now. And what we can do is we can add all our new pages, and we can use the Divi Builder. And on this particular one, we can load from the library, add from library, and we can see all of our pages there. So I'm just going to load up the home page for now. I'm going to publish that. I also need to go to my menus, set up my main menu, create my menu, and I'm going to add my homepage to that menu. So I'm going to set it as my primary menu and save it. Now, let's go and have a look at the site. Now, what we see here is what people see quite a lot, especially new users. One can forget to set the homepage as the page that you want to see. Now, WordPress generally sets your blogging pages as the pages that you want to see. So let's go back to the theme customizer, and we go to our static front page, and we say we want to have a front page display of a static front page, and that would be our home page. Our post page we just leave blank, and we can save and publish that page now. And that's it. That's the child theme installed. You can see that the items are in there, and it's up to you to build out your content and make sure that you are delighted with your new child theme. Now, next, we're going to export this and import it into another WordPress install using the all-in-one migration plugin. So we've installed the child theme, we've put all the pages in, we've put in the different menu items, and we've also done the permalinks to make sure that we've got friendly permalinks. So when we go through to the different sections, the pages look nice on the URL. So the next thing to do is to install a nice little plugin, which is free up to 500 megabyte sites, and that's called All-in-One Migration. Now you can do this from your dashboard. So you just go to Plugins, Add New, and you type in here all in one migration, hit return, and with a bit of luck, all in one migration will turn up first, and it has. So you just simply install that now, activate it, and you go to the menu item on the dashboard and you say export, and you export to a file. Now there are premium options for this to export to Dropbox, Google Drive, Amazon S3, OneDrive, and whatever boxes. And that's now said that I've got a 64 megabyte file, and it says download it. So I'm going to hit on download, and I'm going to put that into my file that I'm using for this particular training session. And I've got that there. It's Charles Theme installed version, so I'll save that down. Now again, depending on your internet connection, that will take either seconds or minutes like mine. I've got a slow internet connection, so bear with it. Now that's done, so you can close that down quite happily. And you can go and view that file in your folder. And it'll say it's a WPress file. And the next thing we do is go to our live site. So we happen to have a spare domain called Love Figures. It was done for an accountant and they decided to go against that name, so it's totally spare, and we can now install the child theme that I installed on the temporary domain. So let's just go to the dashboard, add a new plugin, which is the all-in-one migration. Install that. Activate. Go along to the dashboard menu item and hit import. And we can import from a file. And we know that that file is there. Now, the lovely thing about all-in-one migration is that you can actually just rely on it to change the URLs across the whole site. So once this is imported, we can be assured that it will work perfectly. So that's imported now, and you've got some warning messages. The import process will overwrite your database, media, plugins, and themes, and ensure that you have a backup of your data before proceeding to the next step. Always good advice, but as this is a very clean WordPress install, we don't really need to worry about that. So we just press continue. So that's imported successfully. So what we have to do is now we've got to save our permalink structure twice. So we go to the permalink settings. And that will always ask us to log in. So we've got the username and password from our previous site. We log in, we say save changes, and save changes again. And you can see that it's changed to child theme install. When we visit the site, it will be exactly as it was on the development site. Now realize this is a live site, so we've got everything going for us. The last thing to do is, before you actually go live and tell your client that it's all there, you go to your general settings, reading, and uncheck discourage search engines from indexing this site. Now, I do a little SEO course as well, so it's always a good idea to install an SEO plugin. And anybody who knows me, my preferred option is all-in-one SEO. And that's it for today. So we've learned how to install WordPress. We've learned how to install a dev server for your WordPress development. We've installed a child theme. We've amended all the content. We've backed that up using all-in-one migration. And we've now turned that into a live site as well. So good luck with it and enjoy. And I'll speak to you soon.